Hi, I'm Sukki Singapora. I'm the world's first burlesque artist from Singapore. It's kind of a crazy, a different way I got into the industry, actually. I was working in IT, doing network support, and I was kind of into vintage fashion. I'd heard about the kind of people who wore vintage fashion, and that's when this term burlesque was being knocked about, because the stars of the 90s, the American Hollywood stars, all are advocates of vintage fashion. So I was kind of like, well, what is burlesque? And when I researched it, I was like, oh my gosh, this is like my calling, this is for me. And so I decided to walk down to a local club that was opening down the road from me. It just happened to be at the same time that I kind of heard about what burlesque was. And I don't know what possessed me, but I walked on in there. I said I was a professional, I'd been doing it for years, and they gave me a job. So getting into the burlesque industry was me teaching myself burlesque off of YouTube in 7 days. And the rest is history. Well, I think when I got, even though it was only 5 years ago now that I kind of got into it that way, I think now burlesque has become even more popular, and so huge numbers of people do it. And I think the most common way is they hear about workshops or classes, and they kind of like learn that from scratch, and they learn how to perform, and they learn how to become a stage artist, and then they head towards burlesque shows. I guess I was quite fortunate in that, because I was trained in classical ballet from a young age, I kind of had that stage background and stage presence anyway. So going into it with such little training, I don't want to say easy, but it was kind of easier than people might have imagined a long course of learning, I guess. Ah, my motivation. I don't know. I want to make a difference. And I know that sounds really corny, but it's actually true, because it's super uncommon for somebody from my background, for Asian women, to do something so diverse and so unusual. And for me, it's kind of turned into my mission to create a path so that other people can tread it, because I know how hard it is to do something and to be in a minority group that's kind of always trying to push the boundaries but not succeeding. So I guess, yeah, to create a environment where other people can be free to express themselves is like basically what gets me out of bed and makes me push. Definitely, I didn't used to think about the impact I was having in terms of my career, and I definitely didn't think about my goal being to be in a situation where I could make such a difference. Because when I started in burlesque, I was kind of doing it because it was a personal journey, and what I didn't expect was people would start messaging me saying I'd inspired them to go on and do it, or I'd made a difference, or even that I'd legalized an art form in a country. So for me, my focus was, I just want to do this, I want to explore myself in terms of my sensuality and body confidence. And yes, over the last couple of years, it's definitely transformed into, wow, my success has enabled other people to succeed, and now I really want to utilize that to make a massive difference. I'm not as confident as my stage persona. Sometimes I'm quite shy and very dorky, but I think burlesque and that industry has enabled me to become confident in myself. So I think in terms of being an advocate or representing it, or being a role model in terms of sexual expression, I think basically I'm probably just standing for, if me, the dorkiest human, can like express themselves sensually in a way that looks like I know what I'm doing and I'm feeling confident, then anyone can. And it's just about taking that step, trying new things, having the confidence to explore your body. And I think there's still room to learn. I'm growing as a person, and I still have my hang-ups about this, that, and the other. Everyone does, it's normal. But yeah, I just think that if I can grow and learn that, then anyone can. What a controversial question. If I could change 3 things about the burlesque industry. So I'm just gonna go out on a limb and say, I think I'd make it more enabling for different ethnicities. I think that historically, I find it sad sometimes when I see people always trying to emulate Marilyn Monroe or the Western stars of the 90s in the aesthetic, and I think that it would be great to celebrate more burlesque artists of color. So that's number one. The second thing is bringing men into the dialogue more. Even though burlesque originated or it grew popular, or at least neo-burlesque, from strong female figures, especially in Hollywood, I think bringing guys into the dialogue and really pushing boylesque as a thing that guys shouldn't be nervous about exploring, or it doesn't mean that they have to necessarily take on burlesque in a feminine way. I think that's something that I'd like to see pushed more. And number three, I don't know. There are many things that I would say could always be better. I think not losing the integrity of the art, possibly. I think it's great that burlesque has become super commercial and that it's really been taken up by mainstream society, but I think it's really important for performers to know the history of the art, know where it comes from, really research it and use those references to make it a huge art form and not necessarily just a commercial throwaway thing. Because yes, everyone can do burlesque, but it is important when you're performing, I think, to know the art really well. So I think maybe just for it to, I don't know, keep the focus on the artistic integrity is something that I'd like to see happen a bit more as it evolves in the future. Yes, it's become more popular, and therefore the influx of newcomers has just, when I started, it wasn't so accessible. Now I think every third person knows somebody who's a burlesque artist, and that wasn't something that necessarily was the case when I started. But I think in a way that's a good thing, because it's finally had a focus that it didn't have before. There's more support, new venues are opening, new people are getting involved in the scene, which is great because it means it can change and grow. So yes, it's changed in terms of saturation, I guess. The sheer volume of performers there are now wasn't what there was when I started. In 5 years' time from now, my goodness, I have absolutely no idea. But I think the most important thing for me is, yes, I really care about burlesque and the art, but I also care about my charities that I'm a part of now. And I think when you get higher up in an entertainment industry or even in a celebrity culture, it's really important to give something back from what you essentially took from. And so I'd like to see myself way more involved on the ground with my charities, as well as just being a showgirl. I am the world's worst workaholic. yes, I absolutely take my work home with me. I don't just spoon my cats to sleep, I also spoon my phone. So yeah, I need to stop doing that. But I think with social media and everyone wanting access to every part of your life, how can you not? And I really care about people seeing the real side of me. And the real side of me is kind of like the 24-hour journey per day of getting makeup done and behind the scenes. So yeah, when I go home, or when I'm like away, or if I'm staying in a hotel, pretty much like 24 hours a day, there's something going on. So definitely take my work. I think I always have nervous excitement before a show, and that will never change, I don't think. I think the moment it changes is the moment I stop caring about my art. So for me, before a show, it's all about just centering myself, calming myself, and enjoying the moment and not letting that adrenaline rush completely take over. So still having composure. So yeah, I will usually sit in a changing room, potentially with my backing dancers, and chow down on some chocolate just to chill out. Not gonna lie, that or cake is pretty much my relaxation technique. Even though it's super liberal, I think still the dialogue about sex is, people still get embarrassed about it, and there's a lot of restraint, and people don't necessarily speak about it openly. It's still seen as something that is naughty, and that you should giggle about and you can't talk freely about. Whereas in other places in Europe, that dialogue is a lot more free and there's no shame or embarrassment associated with it. I think the attitudes are very divided in that it's happening. Everyone's involved in the scene, everyone talks about it, but it's always behind closed doors. It's never free to go out in the open. So events like Sexhibition or like Peep Show, bringing it into a format where people can experience it and talk about it publicly is a really great thing for the British mentality. I wish I could be way more cool. I am the most uncool human I know. If I could change one thing, it'd be that I could just walk into a place totally smoothly and be like one of those femme fatales you see. But I'm not. So maybe a little more cool, less of an IT geek, more of a showgirl. Honest, hardworking, loyal, dorky. Oh crap, unicorn? Is it five words that I hope people would describe me as, or five words that they may actually describe me as? I'd like to think that people see me as a good role model, maybe hopefully inspiring, because I work hard to inspire. I don't know, a vampire, because I never damn sleep. A little bit weird, and I don't know, just genuine. I think the advice I would give to myself, I don't know, when I started out in burlesque, is just don't be afraid to be yourself. Don't be afraid of being authentic, and don't be afraid of what other people think of you, because I think the burlesque scene is, even though it's growing, it's still very small, and I think sometimes it's very easy to get fixated on, oh, what will people do if I do this act, or how will people react if I bring in my heritage in? What will people feel like if I wear a putu, or how will people feel if I promote myself in this way or that way, or do something different? And I think when I started back then, I was really nervous of that. And I think a lot of people are. So I think it would just be, you know what, just do what feels right. Enjoy the fact that burlesque doesn't necessarily have any parameters of what is right and wrong. And have the confidence to be yourself more.